Saturn Launch Vehicle Film Report number 38 covers progress of the Saturn 1B and Saturn 5 programs during the period October, November, and December 1968. As this quarter began, final high bay checkout was underway in Kennedy Space Center's Vertical Assembly Building on AS-503, the third Saturn V flight vehicle, and the one whose destiny would be to launch three astronauts on mankind's most awesome journey to the moon. On October 9th, the 503 vehicle, mated to the Apollo 8 spacecraft, which would house astronauts Frank Borman, James Lovell, and William Anders, was slowly moved aboard its mobile launcher, the 3 miles from the VAB to Pad A, Launch Complex 39. Here, the painstaking final preparations and checkouts were performed during the following weeks to ready AS-503 for its historic mission of propelling its Apollo 8 spacecraft to the first lunar orbit. The 6-day pre-launch countdown began on December 15th. It proceeded with only minor problems, which were resolved without impact on the scheduled launch date. At T-minus 28 hours, the actual countdown commenced. At 6:51 a.m. Central Standard Time, only milliseconds off schedule, on Saturday, December 21st, the epical Apollo 8 flight began, its five F-1 engines generating a total of 7.5 million pounds of thrust. The launch vehicle's first, or S-1C, stage performed perfectly. S-1C boosted the vehicle 42 miles at a speed of 6,068 miles per hour. Performance of the S-1C's pogo suppression system was nominal, and indications are that no pogo or excessive longitudinal oscillations existed. S-1C S-2 stage separation occurred at 1:54.5 seconds after liftoff, only 2.4 seconds beyond predicted time. Performance of the second, or S-2 stage, was also very satisfactory and well within tolerance. Powered by its five J-2 engines, the S-2 stage burned for 6 minutes and 9 seconds before cutoff and separation from the S-4B stage. The third, or S-4B stage, was started at 525 seconds into the flight and inserted the Apollo spacecraft into a parking orbit around the Earth. After coasting for 2 hours and 39 minutes, the stage was reignited to place Apollo 8 into translunar injection. Performance of the vehicle's instrument unit was extremely accurate, both in the Earth orbital injection and the translunar injection phases. Reaching the moon after its 230,000-mile journey, Apollo 8 passed within 70 miles of the lunar surface during the spacecraft's 10 lunar orbits. After some 20 hours in lunar orbit, Apollo 8 began its return trip to Earth. Re-entering Earth's atmosphere at 25,000 miles per hour, Apollo 8 splashed down safely on target in the Pacific Ocean near Hawaii. With the historic AS-503 flight accomplished, AS-504, the fourth Saturn V flight vehicle, now becomes the most immediate center of attention. Erection of the AS-504 in the VAB was performed in early October, and checkout and testing have been proceeding without any delay to the launch schedule. Rollout to the launch pad is set for early January. AS-504 is scheduled to launch the Apollo 9 spacecraft on February 28th for a low Earth orbital mission involving the first manned operation of the Apollo's lunar module. All stages for the fifth Saturn V flight vehicle, AS-505, arrived at KSC this quarter from the prime contractors. The S-1C stage was delivered November 30th. The S-2 stage arrived on December 10th. The S-4B stage on December 3rd, and the instrument unit on December 14th. Stacking of the AS-505 vehicle is due in early January. 505 is tentatively scheduled to launch Apollo 10 on a circumlunar mission in mid-May 1969. Saturn V stage contractors were active during the report period in testing stages for future launch vehicles. At NASA's Mississippi Test Facility, static firing tests of S-1C stages 7 and 8 were successfully conducted by Boeing. Also at MTF, static firing of S-26 was conducted in October by North American Rockwell's Space Division, and post-static checkout and modifications have been completed. S-27 has been installed in MTF's other S-2 stand, and preparations are underway for a mid-January firing. At the Sacramento, California facility of McDonnell Douglas, S-4B-7 was static tested in October. Post-static checkout and mods are now finished. Preparations are being made for static firing of S-4B-8 next quarter. A solution to corrosion problems encountered under the new S-2 stage spray foam insulation is now being applied at the contractor's Seal Beach, California facility. The problem had been isolated to the primer used on the aluminum prior to spray foam application. The old primer is being removed, and a new type primer which provides more effective corrosion protection will replace it. In the three-part S-2 stage lightweight structural test program, final testing of the A structure at the Marshall Center was successfully completed in November at 130% of limit load. The S-2 lightweight B-test structure was virtually demolished by an explosion during preparation for a test on December 20th at Santa Susana, California. Cause of the blast was determined to be an inadequate purge of liquid oxygen from the tank prior to start of testing. The test was to simulate S-2 load conditions at S-1C stage cutoff. The destroyed test item is not expected to be replaced. It is believed that extrapolation of data from other tests will provide adequate analysis of the test condition. On November 19th, the S-2 cutoff test condition had been successfully conducted. Testing of the C structure was successfully completed at the Marshall Center during the quarter. Final tests indicating the structure would sustain a 110% limit load without failure. At the Huntsville facility of the Saturn V instrument unit contractor, IBM, installation of modification kits and retest operations continued on various IUs throughout the report period. The fifth Saturn 1B flight vehicle, designated AS-205, was launched on October 11th from Launch Complex 34 of the Kennedy Space Center, placing the first manned Apollo spacecraft, Apollo 7, into Earth orbit. AS-205 performed flawlessly as it lifted astronauts Walter Schirra, Don Isley, and Walter Cunningham to what would be an almost 11-day stay in space. The vehicle's first or S-1B stages propulsion and mechanical systems operated very satisfactorily, within 0.2% of predicted performance values. This included the fuel pressurization, liquid oxygen pressurization, control pressure, and engine systems. Stage separation occurred at 145.5 seconds after liftoff, only about 1 second beyond predicted time. Performance of the second or S-4B stage and associated systems was also perfect. S-4B burn time was 470 seconds, within 1 second of nominal. The instrument unit's guidance and control systems performed with extreme precision. Apollo 7 was inserted into an orbit of 173.6 miles apogee and 137.9 miles perigee. All launch vehicle mission objectives were accomplished, including evaluation of the J-2 engine augmented spark igniter line modification. With its fifth successful flight and as many launches, the Saturn 1B launch vehicle has now completed its mission in Project Apollo. The 9 remaining vehicles of the 14 ordered by NASA will now be placed in storage until the beginning of the Apollo Applications Program flights in 1971. Their separate components, either complete, in assembly, or undergoing modifications, will be stored and kept in readiness by their respective manufacturers until reactivated for AAP. 7 of the 9 S-1B stages have been completed, and assembly is in progress on the last 2 by the Chrysler Corporation Space Division at NASA's Michoud Assembly Facility in New Orleans. Storage of 7 completed S-4B stages for Saturn 1B vehicles is being accomplished by the prime contractor, McDonnell Douglas, at its Sacramento, California facility. The final two stages will be completed by working them into the Saturn V production schedule as an economy measure. S-IVB is common to both launch vehicles. All but two of the Saturn 1B instrument units have been completed and are being stored by IBM Huntsville. The remaining units will be worked into the Saturn V assembly schedule. Maintenance of all stored Saturn 1B vehicle components for the resumption of launches for AAP will be required of all prime contractors. Systems are being developed for keeping the stages in controlled environments to prevent any possible deterioration. In summation, the report period October-November-December 1968 witnessed the culmination of years of effort in its two historic milestones, the launching of the first manned Apollo spacecraft by AS-205 and the AS-503 launch, which resulted in man's first rendezvous with the moon.